Alright, well guys, so I wanted to do a video on because I went to Petland yesterday and I've been teaching a lot of people because Petland gives a lot of misinformation, so I've been teaching a lot of people about fish. So I just want to make a video or a bunch of videos on how to properly like the basic knowledge you need for a fish. I'm gonna try and keep it as basic as possible. Because this is for all, like, the newbies out there. Like, most of, like, everyone that is probably as experienced as me or more experienced knows all this stuff. So, first of all, there's four types of tanks, or there's four, in my opinion, types of tanks. You need to first decide what type of tank you're going to get. Now, this is all based on the size of the tank, how much money you're willing to put in, how much effort. So, I'm going to talk about the four different types that I believe there are. Now, the first type, which is probably the most popular, is the community tank. Now, a community tank is basically a tank that has mostly or all fake plants, and it just has a bunch of fish that, you know, people find interesting, such as guppies, or mollies, or gouramis, or something like that. And it's so popular because, you know, there's no maintenance involved. You don't have to take any really risks to do anything. You just really gotta follow the basic laws of fish keeping, and then your tank looks amazing for a community tank. So that's probably the easiest, and most people like it and prefer it. The next type is planted tank. This is where all of your plants are real, and your tank is pretty well planted. Now, these planted tanks, the only downside is that if you kill plants, you're going to be very depressed. There's a little bit more money that goes involved, but it's a lot easier to take care of and maintain, unless you're trying to do a really, like, densely planted tank, then you'd have to take some risks and worry about, you know, the actual fish. But for that, I mean, there's different levels. If you're doing, like my basic type, like, if this was just, like, this could be considered a lightly planted tank for now. So this tank would require very little effort. I could get away with no dirt, and it would be fine. On the other hand, if you have some really non-hardy species like red tiger lotus and a lot of the red plants, you're going to need higher light, which means more electricity bill. You're going to need dirt, which means, or any kind of, you know, eco-substrate, which is like a risk. You need to know what you're doing. And if you really want to go there, you could use CO2, which, again, you need to know what you're doing. So, it ranges. The next type is a cichlid setup. Now, the cichlid setups, again, you don't really need to know too much basic knowledge. It's basically the basic laws of fish keeping, but you do need to know cichlid. All the cichlid laws, as I call them, because cichlids, honestly, I call three basic types of fish: freshwater, four, freshwater, northern and southern lakes, cichlids, and saltwater and brackish water. So five. I call cichlids in their own group because they're just a very different fish. It's very hard to keep them with other types of fish. But you do need to know what you're doing with them. You can't have too many fish in the tank or you'll just wind up killing them. It's very hard to get plants in there. Sometimes you can get Anubias and Java Fern in there, but it's pretty tough. It's a lot more work. Honestly, I don't think they're worth it. Some people do, just because they look cool. And you need to have a big tank. For the community, you can go as small as a 2-gallon all the way up to, like, a 50, whatever size you can get up to. For the planted tanks, again, small all the way to large. Cichlid tanks, on the other hand, I suggest 30 gallon or higher, depending on what cichlids you're trying to get. Now, the other type is exotics. Exotics as in, and this is all for freshwater only, exotics is things like gars, maybe sunnies, trouts, things that live in northern or southern far ponds and need to be kept in cooler temperatures. Things like, I'm trying to think, tadpoles, frogs, stuff like that. They need an exotic setup. Now, exotic setups would require, if it's like frogs, then you can get a small tank. 10 gallon might work, depending. But if you're doing gars or something, you're going to need like 120, 140 gallon. Now, these are very, or piranhas. There was the other one. Piranhas are another one. You need to have a very big tank, and you need to really know what you're doing with those fish, and it's going to require a lot of work. You can't put too many fish in there, but on the other hand, you're going to get a lot of fame. Hey, this guy has piranhas. Let's go see him. Let's try this. Let's do that. But honestly, a lot of the, it's really not worth it. I'm just going to put that out there. It's not worth it to have an exotic tank because the fish are normally very, very boring. Gars just swim around extremely slowly. Piranhas, the only interesting part is when you feed them. Otherwise, they just hide all day. I'm trying to think. Trout are okay, but they need a big tank. Sunnies, kind of boring. They don't really do much. I mean, that's just my thoughts. So those are the basic four setups.